Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. In this video, I want to talk about the adrenal glands. Now, I have a lot of different videos on different aspects of the adrenal, but I don't think I have a video just on the basics of what the adrenal glands do. Now, there are two glands right on top of the kidney, right down in here, and they are stress glands. So the body will respond to physical and mental stress with the help of the adrenal glands. So the adrenal glands basically adapt the different parts of your body to a stress so it can cope. For example, if you're being chased by a tiger, the adrenal gland will produce hormones to activate more blood flow to the muscle, increase heart rate, increase blood pressure, mental acuity, so you're all set to prepare yourself for flight, runaway, or fight, okay? So the adrenal gland is very unique because it has an outside and an inside. The outside is all gland tissue. The inside is not gland tissue, it's nerve tissue. It's interesting. So you have this gland wrapped around a nerve bundle, and the nerve bundle makes neurotransmitters. And probably because of its location, it can have quick access to the heart and different organs because it's right in the center of the body. But it makes adrenaline, noradrenaline, which is a pre-adrenaline hormone. It also makes catecholamines, which are things like dopamine, serotonin, GABA, all the different neurotransmitters are made there. And it's part of the sympathetic nervous system, which again, is the flight or fight mechanism. It's right inside the adrenal. Now the outside has primarily three categories of hormones, maybe four if you want to classify them a little differently. The first one is called glucocorticoids, which is basically cortisol. And by the way, all these hormones are steroids that are made from cholesterol. That's why you need a certain amount of cholesterol to make them, especially under stress. But the glucocorticoids, the name gives it away, glucose. Okay, they're hormones that do influence blood sugars. Okay, so that's why if you have too much of that hormone, you can end up becoming a diabetic. Because it produces, it turns basically things into sugar pretty quickly, your own muscle. So it makes quick energy. So if it has too much, it's going to trigger insulin and you're going to get all sorts of issues. This is the one that I talk about producing belly fat, but really only through insulin because it increases insulin. So insulin is the main hormone that does it, but it's cortisol that can trigger it. So cortisol affects stress, blood sugars, immune suppression. Now think about all the autoimmune diseases out there. You know, where your body attacks its own tissue. And then what's the treatment for all of them? Steroids, prednisone. What's a steroid? An adrenal hormone, cortisol. So your own body is supposed to produce hormones to counter that and suppress stress. In fact, if you look at the remedy, prednisone, and what conditions it treats, all sorts of skin problems, pain syndromes, inflammatory conditions, immune conditions, organ rejection type hormone. So everything with immune suppression. So it affects the immune system big time. If the adrenal glands are weakened, it makes you susceptible to viruses. So it's really an important hormone. It actually affects bone. So if you have too much of this hormone, you can have bone loss. Controls vitamin D levels. So you could be low in vitamin D from the adrenal being stressed out. So it does a lot. Okay. So the next one is mineral corticoids. That would be a hormone that controls the electrolytes, potassium, calcium, magnesium, chlorides, sodium. So it really controls the electrolytes and the sodium fluid balance in the body. And that's one of the reasons why people might get high blood pressure. They give you a diuretic because you have a sodium imbalance. It's affecting this hormone right here. The name of it is called aldosterone. Okay, then we have androgens, which is male hormones. Females have androgens, men have more, but the adrenal gland also produces androgens. It also produces estrogen. Interesting. So when a female goes through menopause, the adrenal gland literally has to work a little harder to back up the loss of the ovarian function, and that's where it comes from, that adrenal. Also, then you have DHEA, which is kind of a precursor hormone that turns into these other hormones. So if you're low in DHEA, which most people are as they age, you lose your vitality, you lose your energy, your ability to sleep, but it's really the adrenal gland. So what do? They live on stimulants. They start to try to live on coffee and things to wake them up, 5-hour energy drinks to try to wake them up. The problem is the stimulants kind of stimulate the adrenal and keep it going, but then it kind of burns out over more and you become adrenal fatigued and you're tired and now you can't sleep. And the last thing is make sure when you eat, you have enough potassium in the food, because potassium is a calming mineral. It relaxes the adrenal. And when you're deficient in potassium, everything kind of speeds right up. All right, thanks for watching. Hi guys, hey listen, I created a pretty amazing evaluation quiz down below that actually analyzes your symptoms to find the cause, the root cause of all of your symptoms, the most likely cause. So take the quiz now and we'll send you a report.